Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Coding Together. My name is Vikas Hoja. Today we will see another lead code problem, that is coin change. It's a very popular question, as you can see from the thumbs up. It's a medium level question. So let's read the problem statement first. So you are given with an integer array coins representing coins of different denominations and an integer amount representing a total amount of money. So we have coins that represent different denominations. And what we have to do is we have to pick the fewest number of coins that need to make up to that amount, irrespective of the combinations of the coins. So suppose, let's see this example, it will make this problem statement more clear, that we are given with the coins 1 to 5 and with an amount equal to 11. Now what minimum number of coins I can take from these denominations of the coin to make the sum amount to 11? That is 3. How? If we take 5, that is 5 coin with denomination 5 and another coin with a denomination 5 plus third coin with a denomination of 1, they will sum up to 11. And this is the minimum number of coins we need, right? Similarly, let's see this example. We are given with only a denomination of coins, that is 2. So we have to give the minimum number of coins that will amount to 3. We cannot make 3 with the denominations of 2, right? Because it will go 2 plus 2 plus 2, so on. So let's understand. So if, like, we have understood the problem clearly, right, with the help of examples. Now let's see what steps comes into mind to choose the problem, to choose the solution of this problem. So first is like brute force. So brute force for this problem, we can that comes into mind is brute force. So how brute force, for example, for this problem, we can do is like backtracking, like recursively find all the combinations, right? And all the combinations, like, suppose if we saw the example, like for 11, we had 1 to 5. So we can do 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus, this is one combination. We can do 2 plus 2 plus 2 plus 1, something like 2 to 2, 2 plus 1, that is one combination. 5 plus 5 plus 5 plus 1, that is combination. So we can do all these combinations and some of them will not meet the answer, some of them will meet the answer. So we have to find the best combination that will meet the criteria or the problem statement. So we will use backtracking to recursively find all the combinations, because we cannot just write it on the paper for the larger number of values. So here the recursion helps in, you know, finding all the combinations, because for smaller numbers we can write it down on the paper, but for the larger numbers we have to go for the smaller numbers and then add and solve those smaller sub problems to make it the larger sub problem. So if we see for this backtracking, recursively find all combinations. If we talk about recursion, FS, what does FS means? What does FS stands for? That find the minimum number of coins for amount S, right? And what we can say for FS is like FS will be equal to F S minus C plus 1. Now let's understand this recursive cosine formula that to find the minimum number of coins for FS, I need to find the minimum number of coins for a amount, smaller amount that will be given by subtracting the denomination of the coins. And what this FS minus C is? Minimum. Let's try to understand this. FS minus C1, FS minus C2, dash 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 FS minus CN, where N is the number of coins. N is the number of length of the coins, where each is like each value is the denomination of the coins. So if we find a sum of the amount or the amount for FS, minimum number of coins for amount S, we have to find we can say that we can solve for some smaller amount which will be given by subtracting each denomination and taking the minimum of it. Right? We subtract the amount, we subtract the coin denomination from the S given, we'll reach a value, right? Because this will be value 1, this will be value 2, this will be value 3. Value n, so on. When we subtract C1 or all the denominations, we'll reach a value, right? And we have to take the minimum of it and just add one into it, because we know that if we have gone for an amount lesser than by subtracting that denomination coin, if we add one to it, one of the denomination coin that for which we got the minimum value, it will give the minimum amount of coins for the amount S. Right? So this is our recursion formula. Let's see the base conditions. So for base conditions, it will be F0 equal to 0 and F less than 1 or less than 0, sorry, will be max, int max, because for F0 equal to 0 means for minimum number of coins for amount 0 will be equal to 0, and for amount less than 0 it will be the max, because we have to compare minimum and we have to ignore the path where the amount becomes less than 0, because it is not desirable, it's not the requirement of the question. So to ignore it, we'll take int max. Now let's see how we can use this recursion formula to find out all the combinations for amount equal to 4, which has coin denominations as 1, 2. So for amount 4, we have to go to a amount by subtracting each denominations. We have to go to a amount by subtracting each denomination. So if I subtract minus 1, it will go to 3. If I subtract minus 2, it will go to 2. So we have to go to the sum. From amount 4, we have to go to an amount by subtracting each denominations, by trying all the combinations of the denominations. And then we'll ask for the minimum number of coins for that sum. And we will add 1 to it, because we have subtracted that one coin of that denomination to reach that sum, always. So if we reached 3, decreased only one count of that denomination of the coin, Here also I decreased only one count of denomination 2. So the reduction is only one of different denominations. So the branching factor, number of branches from a node, will be the number of denominations of the present in the coin. So from 4 we do minus 1 reach 3, minus 2 will reach 2, from 3 again minus 1 will reach 2, minus 2 1, from 2 also we'll do minus 1 minus 2, all the denominations available, we'll have to branch for all the denominations. From 1 we'll do minus 1 minus 2, we reached our base condition. For base condition, what we have written, 50 is equal to 0, so we'll return 0, and we'll return for minus 1 max. So now here, let's, for here at 1, we have to ignore this path, we have to ignore this path, because this is not acceptable. So what we will do is, we will do minimum of 0 comma max and do plus 1, because what we are saying, for 1 I will subtract 1 1 from 1, right, the denomination 1, the coin 1 from 1, I'll reach an amount, and I'll find the minimum ways, minimum number of coins to make that amount. So for 0 it needs 0 coins. Also this will ignore this, but to make 1 we have to add 1, because from 1 to 0 I had subtracted like that denomination of count 1. So that's why we'll add at every node, 1 at every node. So now from 0, so from here we'll return 1, from here it will be 0. So again at 2 it will be minimum 1 comma 0 plus 1, that will be 1, right? So from 2, we have seen from 2 what is returning, 1, right? So from here 2, the same thing, minimum 1 comma 0 plus 1, if I do the same, right? So let's do it. So for 1 it will return 1, we reach 3, we'll go iterate over the next denomination, that is minus 2, we reached 1, and again we'll do minus 1 minus 2. From 0 will return 0, from minus 1 it will be max, and from 1 it will be again 1, and at 3 we will do minimum of 1 comma 1 plus 1, that will be 2. So for 2 we have already done that, it will return 1. So from here it will also return 1 from all this, from this subtree sub, and here we will again do minimum of 2 comma 1 plus 1, that will be 2. So for 4, what are the minimum coins required is 2 plus 2 equal to 4. So let's so what is the time complexity, what will be the time complexity for this brute force? That will be, because at each level, at each node, we are traversing n times, where n is number of coins. If n is number of coins, then we are traversing, we are branching out n times from each node. And what is the maximum sub problem we are solving here? Like, what is the maximum length of the recursion tree? It is equal to amount A. Like if I subtract 1, 1, 1, 1, right? Like, so it can go from 4 to, it will be equal to 4, the maximum length. So it will, the time complexity will be order of NA. Now let's see how memoization, that is dynamic programming, can optimize this solution. So we know that dynamic programming, we do is we break the larger optimal to find the larger optimal solution. We find the optimal solution for smaller subproblems. So can we memoize? So there is one more technique for dynamic programming. Here we will talk about memoization. In the next video we'll talk about the tabulation or the iterative way. So if I talk about the memoization, can we see some subproblems repeating? Yes, we can see subproblems repeating here. If you see this part, this is being repeated here, here, and here. So this is being repeated 3 times. So if we cache it, this the solution, the outcome of this subproblem, we can save the recursion the next time it occurs, this subproblem. So this is the we'll make a DP or the cache, and for every amount, A stand for amount, we'll store the result, so that next time for any denomination we receive that segment, or the next time for any sub problem we'll use it. So if you see the above diagram, here we were again having that sub problem, so we will take it from cache or from the DP. So now how memoization will reduce the time complexity? So it will be n into a, big O of n into a, because the maximum times the sub problem will be done is a. We have to solve a sub problems at least. The maximum sub problems is a, right? That is the length of the recursion tree, because it will have a sub problems at least for every node at least, right? A sub problem for each amount, for each amount 1 to a, it will have sub problems. Now for each sub problem we are taking n branches, so it will be n into a big O of. Let's see the time complexity. This is the time complexity. The space complexity will be order of a, because maximum, as we know, the recursion tree stores in the stack. So the maximum stack that can be filled is the maximum height of the recursion tree, that will be equal to the a. This is the amount that the so the maximum stack can be order of a, because there can be a segments, a subproblems, right? So let's see the code part of it. So if the amount is less than equal to 0, so I've taken Java here. So as we have understood the problem, so the language is not, should not be a barrier. We can write, you know, code in any language. My preferred language is Java. So if amount is less than 1, we'll return 0, because for 0 it will be 0 coins. We'll initialize our DP to achieve memoization. We'll fill it with -1. We'll start our recursion helper method here. So if in the recursion helper method, first we are checking our base conditions, and in the thirdly we are taking from the cache if that is not equal to -1. If it's already reached, means that sub problem is already done. Now we have to take all the combinations of that coin, and we have to subtract, we have to go to an amount for which there will be, we have to go to amounts for which we have to find the minimum number of coins, right? So we have to run this loop for coins.length times, because for each coin denomination we have to find a sum, right, a smaller sum for which we can find the optimal solution, right? We have to iterate for each, for every node we have to take HN branches that denotes the number of denominations of the coins to find the minimal number of coins. And finally, if coin is not equal to integer dot max value, that means we don't have to ignore that. Then we'll take the maximum of CC that is already the variable that we initialized, right? For out of the coins dot length iterations, we have to take the minimum. That's this line will do. And finally, we'll store in the DP and return CC. So let's try to run this program and let's see if run successfully. So yeah, it's running successfully. So I hope you understand this problem and the solution and the approach, the technique. So if you like this video, please share and subscribe. Thanks for your support, guys.